you're all doing great. Please be safe and be healthy. In today's video, we have a special and also most requested video. I'm doing it a few days back. If you're following my videos regularly, we have done a video with Srividya, who is an acupuncture specialist. So when we have done that video, a lot of responses came in a positive way. Everybody was requesting, you know, they wanted to know some more information. So I have requested Vidya to give some more information on a special request base. So she has given her time and added a lot of value addition, important points. So today she will be giving a little more information about acupuncture. So let's hear from her. Here is Vidya.
Hi friends, was very happy to get to know that you are all excited to know about acupuncture. Today I've got few more points to share with you which will excite you. I don't want to dump you with too many things as I said last day, but I was very happy that you want to know more from many people coming. Thanks for the opportunity to Divya, I got to explain a few points. Today I would like to say how, you know, in Eastern science, you know, today if you see Western science, you have a specialist in each and every part of the body. Whereas in Eastern science, everything in acupuncture comes into five elements. Panchabhuta they call. So that's how they measure everything throughout the body in Panchabhuta. They put all the organs into each element. And with that only we learn how the body is performing. Okay. For example, I will give you what is the Panchabhuta, how it is connected to your internal organs. Okay. Last time I told you about internal and external organs, how it is connected. This time, how internal organs is connected to Panchabhuta. By keeping this Panchabhuta in the right way, we can keep our body as a star performer. Okay. So if you take fire element, okay, heartbeat, okay, heartbeat and hunger is the fire element in the body. We are alive because of the heartbeat and we eat. That is the reason, okay, that is the fire element. The second is the earth element, okay. Earth element is, if you talk about earth element, it is stomach and spleen. Okay, there is a small organ which is like a small tongue in the stomach, which is like the indicator. Oh, okay, today she has consumed two idlis, one chutney. Like that indicator will understand what food has come inside the stomach and inform the liver how much, oh, today she didn't eat, she is fasting. All these things, the spleen will indicate the liver, because with that, liver will supply the enough acid to digest. Okay. Then if you see the air element, if you see the internal air element organs connected are large intestine and lungs. Okay, as you breathe, you know how it works. Same way, large intestine, the gas releases and everything goes. This is a air element. If you see water element, kidney, urinary bladder, and for ladies, uterus. These three organs are connected to the water element. And finally, the space. Okay, for space, which they call in acupuncture as tree or wood, things like that. These two important organs are liver and gallbladder. Okay, this is how all the organs, internal organs, are put into this five elements. Okay. So by understanding this five elements, what should I do? You know, why you are telling me all these things is will be your question, right? See, if we understand this, okay, we can balance our own things and keep ourselves healthy. Finally, that's the thing we want. Everybody wants to be healthy and want to live for 100 years in a healthy way and enjoy the things that we buy. So this how it works. When there is a fire, okay, then if the wood is proper, the tree is grown well, it will come into the fire. It burns well. You will get a good earth, okay. When the earth element is stable, it will release good air around your body. The prana, the air within you will be balanced. When the air is good, you will create good water. Okay. And the good water will make the trees grow well. That's how this has to, our cycle has to happen. That's the reason our organs all work in a proper time. If you Your parents used to say, get up early, you know, you are irritated, mom, you know, I just want to sleep today. But if you really see the elements, all these elements in the organs, they have their own organ chart, okay? It's not that they don't work other day. It's that just like your maths teacher is in the school only, but when our period comes, she comes and speaks to you. Same way, if you take a, why motion has to happen in the morning? Why not, you know, afternoon? The organs work in such a way that morning, if you take early morning, 3 to 5, those days they call it as Brahma Murta, get up early, get the good air, right? Swamiji's you. See, the, if you go and see the rishis, they don't eat so much manchuris and chicken biryani, everything, but only with balancing their air and water, they are fine, correct? They don't eat much, just by balancing pranayama. Prana means the breath, yama means exercise. By giving the exercise to the prana itself, and they balance all the elements. They don't eat too much. So we can do that. By balancing the just the air element, both the sides can be balanced, possible. They were doing. How? Because the early morning 3 to 5 Brahma Murta, our body gets charged up for the day. Okay? Between 3 to 5, our body will be charging, and when the spine is erect, human is the only thing where spine keeps erect, we can charge the whole spine, okay? Because of which all the energy level will be absolutely high. Then comes 5 to 7 is our large intestine, okay? Where that's how the motion time is ideal. And 7 to 9 and 9 to 11. Is the time for stomach. That's the reason they say that eat like prince. You know, the breakfast should be very good because that is the stomach time. Hey, give me. What are you planning to give? The stomach will be so excited. Just imagine eyes and this thing. Hey, what are you planning to give today? And you say that nothing. Or you just dump in a pizza which will only give you calorie, but you know, what about my nutrients? Correct? So 7 to 9, 9 to 11, you give ideally idlis or dosas or rotis and meat. Heavy breakfast, and between 9 to 11 the spleen will be working, will be in, you know, informing liver, hey, so many things have come, you know, release so much enzyme so that it is digested. Between morning 11 to 1 is heart functioning time, it's in the peak, okay? Ideally don't eat much in that time. You have to think, and whichever needs more of thinking and activity related is the ideal time to do max and things like that. Okay, 1 to 3 is the time for small intestine. Why lunchtime? You know, so lunchtime is when intestine will be like, oh, I'm ready, you know, I can digest whatever you are going to give. It will be like that, you know, just like your PT period. You know? Hey, yes, let's play. Like that, it will be looking, oh, what is the time that you're going to. If you see 3 to 5, evening time, you have your chai or, you know, tender coconut, that is the time for urinary bladder. So, better to give any kind of drink that is good one, okay, good drinks. Like tender coconut is ideal if you have a very hot heat, your body is very hot and pitta. So 3 to 5. 5 to 7 is kidney time, okay? That's when, you know, you have to do more of exercise and, you know, run and drink a lot of water. Between 3 to 7 is water consuming time. You can assume that, you know, body is 70% and above full, you know, water. So if you see earth is also 70% water, same way your body is also 70% water. So by drinking water within you, you can balance it. Those days you see that, you know, munis, and if you read some Panchatantra stories, they take little teertha, some gangesh, some slokas they will tell and drink little, that thirst will go. That's how they do all these things, because this little water can, you know, completely crystallize the water inside you. By telling few mantras and this thing, if you put it inside purely, inside all your elements, like water element is more, which is blood, everything will form a beautiful crystal formation. That's how you can, when you drink water, you can tell good slokas and drink. You know, one of my friend has done actually, you know, good thoughts around the bottle. And you know, thank you, you know, you are a pure water, like that. You know, really appreciate. And if you see 7 to 9, it is pericardium time, okay? Very ideal to make business decisions and, you know, It is a prime time. If you see all the serials, they will focus on 7 to 9 because you are very emotionally connected that time. All the best advertisements in TV are all put in that time because they make money. Because that time you are emotional, man, look, this paste, that tomorrow I have to grab it. Because that feel will come because your pericardium is working that time. And with 9 to 11, if you see night, it's called triple warmer in your body. If you're warm, 98.4 or 98.6, which is ideal, that is because of the triple warmer. No, upper warmer, middle warmer, lower warmer, it is considered in Eastern science. That function is very high. So that's the reason they say don't eat after, 7 to 9, finish or at least some kanji will do. If you want to be really rich and healthy, you should, drink only kanji in the night. Okay, that is one of the suggestions. And night 11 to 1 is liver repairing time. That's the reason they say sleep before 11. So everything they told is for a reason, right? If you want to sleep at 9 also fine, and get up by Brahma Muhurta. Because when the spine works ideally well, ideas will pop up like this. You can do big businesses, you can, do a lot of things. But what we do right now is 11 to 1 we want to slog. That means you are cutting the wood and wood and wood. It's not that it won't help. A lot of people work that way. But it means that you're cutting the wood that time. You're not growing trees. Because of which, 100 plus, not possible. Correct? Okay. So, 70 is possible with good food habits. That is how 1 to 3 is gallbladder time. Where, acid level and acidity, if you have gallbladder stone, all these things might be you're working on shifts and stressing yourself. This is 11 to 3 is ideal time to balance all your pitta and repairing, everything is done between that time. So better to give rest to the body so that morning it gets charged up. That is how this organ chart works. Okay, hope it made a lot of sense for you this time. I would like to add some more points in your next video. Catch up.